Hello friends, welcome to Learn One. In previous lecture, we have learned about class methods in Ruby. And today, we will going to learn about class and its method, how to define class, how to define methods, and some practical stuff. Class and its method. In Ruby, everything is object. So, each and every object belongs to any class. For example, string, boolean, hash, etc. And in Ruby, we are having rich sets of predefined built-in libraries, predefined built-in class that we can use to develop our code. In Ruby, a class is defined by a specific keyword class. Any Ruby class is started with a first capital letter. So if we wanted to add some small letter, then that is must compulsory to start a class name with an capital A to Z, uppercase letter. For example, we can see in a screen, I have created two examples. First is learn1, that's L and V, both are in a capitalized form. And in second, we are having user object. So U and O both are in capital letter. So this is how we can add or we can create class names. In Ruby, for class names, we are using camel case. We can see in a screen the syntax, how actually the class is defined. We need to write the predefined keyword class and the class name, and the definition ends with a predefined keyword of Ruby, that is end. The variables and the methods that we are going to define into our class definition, that all are in a snake case. So we are not using upper letter or we are not using camel case for defining our methods and class. For example, I want to create one variable which is having some longer name, so I can add an underscore in between two that names. For example, learn_1, so it's kind of learn1 user_object. So this is how class methods and variable names has been defined into the Ruby class definition. How to create instance of a class? So for creating instance of a class, we are using a method of Ruby that is new. So by using this new method, we can easily create an instance of any class. For example, my class name is user and I want to create an object. I want to create an instance of that user class. So what I need to do is, I need to write the class name, that is user, and the new method. So user.new, this will return an instance of user class. The new method that we are using is always returns an object, an instance of the defined class. Here in the screen, you can see the example that I have created one instance. In this example, my class name is learn1. So I have created one variable learn1 object equal to my class name, that is learn1 dot the method, that is new. And that will return an instance of my learn1 class. How to define and call the methods in Ruby? So in our class, mainly we are having two types of method. First is instance method and second is class methods. There is also another method, that is a constructor type of method that we have previously seen, that is initializer method, that we have seen in previous tutorial. In Ruby, any method will return an object. Now this object can be of any type. For example, it's an object of string, it's an object of number, it's an object of hash, etc. In Ruby, we do not need to specifically write the return keyword. So for example, if you forgot to write a return statement into your method definition, Ruby will return the value of last executed statement as a return value. In next lecture, we will learn about the attributes. Attribute reader, attribute writer, and attribute accessor.